Hey guys, Nate Harvey with LeadFTS.com. Today we're going to feature a newer product on our site called the Iron Neck. When you're training group athletes that are involved in contact sports, you have to train the neck. The problem with training the neck is many times the equipment that you use is very expensive and takes up a lot of space. With the Iron Neck that Andy has here, we can train the neck very effectively in many different planes of motion without taking up a lot of space and without killing your budget. So we're gonna go ahead here. Andy's gonna put this on and we'll show you how to go through this. You want it even on your head, and then he's gonna adjust his tension. There's a pump on the side here. And what that does is lock the piece in with your head. With traditional neck harnesses, a lot of times you can't adjust the exact size of your head. So this will fit nice and snug. His top strap's already set in place. What you want when you put this on should be lined up right with your forehead, so it's nice and even. And then the chin strap down here is nice and snug, okay? And then he's gonna come in. There's also elastic bands available with this, but we're gonna use the cable, which is a little more optimal. When you set your cable height, your cable that comes out should be basically parallel with the floor, okay? So for the first movement, Andy's gonna step back. Is that good tension-wise? Yeah. Okay, so the athlete's gonna step back. His torso is gonna be straight up and down, okay? He's gonna lock his neck in place, and all he's gonna do is spin his entire body around 5 times each direction. And he's doing a good job. You can see the Iron Neck itself is out nice and even with the floor. Keep your torso straight up and down best you can. Yep. So he did 5 the one way and then just go back the other way. Okay, you're good. Now come in and rest. We're gonna let him come and rest. Okay, good. So that's your first movement. All right, go ahead and step out again. The next movement is look left, look right. So you have 4 different positions. Okay, so first position, he's facing forward and he's just gonna keep his head nice and level and nice and smoothly. Look left to right, a little slower. There you go, good. So just a nice smooth motion, keep going. Back and forth. We'll go 5 each direction on this. So over and back is 1. Okay, good. Now he's gonna turn around and face out, opposite direction. Keep his torso straight up and down in line with his neck. Go ahead, 5 each way. There you go. Okay, now he's gonna turn away from me and be lateral to the machine and go 5 reps there. And then turn and face me. So we hit all 4 directions and 5 reps there. Okay, good. Let him come in, rest a second. Okay, next one, go ahead and step out, is the lock neck body turn. So again, we have 4 positions. He's gonna lock his hips in place, kind of put your hands in front of you like you're praying. And now he's gonna turn his entire torso and his neck is gonna move with his torso and turn to the side and then come back to me, all the way back. There you go, 5 of those. Back and forth, 5. Yep. Again, on this one, try to keep your head locked into your torso. I'll turn around the opposite direction, hit the same thing. This is good because it mimics a lot of the forces you might see on a field or in a wrestling match or heading a ball in a soccer match. Okay, turn and face the other way, away from me. Yep, away, yep, 5 reps. And then face me, 5 reps. Run. Okay, good, step in. Next one is figure eights. Now we only have 2 positions for this one, so we're gonna face the machine and have the athlete basically draw a figure 8 with their nose. Yep, and you're gonna do 8 figure 8s each direction. So he'll do 8 this way, and when he's done with those 8 reps, he'll come back the opposite direction, do 8. And this is why the air bladder on the unit is so important. You couldn't do this with a regular neck harness or a traditional neck machine. And then the other one, just face out from the machine. There you go, go ahead, 8 each direction. So even if you do have the budget and space for a traditional large neck machine that you sit in, this would be a great supplement to that too. Okay, good, relax. Okay, next one is protraction, retraction. So the athlete will step out, and they're basically gonna push your nose out as far as you can, and then pull it back as far as you can, and go 8 of those. It's good. The mistake you'll see on this a lot is the athlete will try to look up as they come back. You don't want to do that. He's even here again and just protract, retract. And then turn around, face away from the machine. 8 reps there. Good. Notice how he's going nice and slow. All his reps are nice and smooth. Another thing you'll see is your athletes will try to get herky-jerky with it. Okay, relax. Last one is diagonal, so go ahead and step out. 2 positions on this one. And what we're gonna do is have the athlete look over at their shoulder, so point their shoulder down towards their nose, and then look up away the opposite direction. Yep, good. So when they're doing this one, 8 reps. When they're doing this one, the iron neck is gonna be sitting at an angle. And then the opposite direction, yep, good. So you hit both shoulders facing the machine and both shoulders looking away from the machine. Okay, and then turn around. And then shoulder. Yep. All right, you're good. Relax. I'll get you out of there and take it off. So, like you see, it's a real quick series. What I would do is the unit comes with a picture and description of the exercises. I'd blow that up, paste it on the wall so your athletes can see it, and you can run them through a quick neck circuit within a couple minutes, and that way it's easy and efficient to fit into your workouts.